I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut. Hey everybody, how you doing? Can you see me? There I am, right there. Can you see my head? Yeah. Okay, what we actually have here, this is a wheel simulator. You know what the difference between a wheel simulator and a hubcap is? Probably about 20 bucks. I got this to go on the van. Because as far as exterior modifications go, this one is actually pretty inexpensive. What we actually have here is chromed ABS plastic. This is an 8-lug style that goes on Dodges, which just happened to have what I have right here. There's all sorts of weird reflections going on. It's all distorted with the stuff that's in the background. What the deal is that I could have bought rims to man this thing up and make my van look super manly, but I didn't because rims are expensive. And by the time I put tires on, it's even more expensive. So as far as making a camper van goes, and as far as exterior modifications go, to make your van look all cool and stuff, wheel simulator is probably not a bad way to go. And here's the deal, if this breaks, I hit a curb, it cracks, whatever, I lose it, it's not a big deal because it can be replaced for relatively inexpensively. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is actually put these on the van and see what they look like. But if somebody has purchased one of these and is looking for a way to figure out how to install these, I'm going to help you out. Okay, what you actually have is you have the ring. This ring goes in the inside of the assembly, the hubcap, wheel simulator, depends how much you paid for it, just like that. You have grooves in the inside there, there we go. This groove right here is for a standard size rim. So if this is 16 inches, this is what you use. If you're using a, or if you need a larger size, if you slide it down, because there's two grooves, oops, if you slide it down, it'll actually expand the teeth, which are these things right here. It makes them stick out a little bit further and it'll fit a little tighter. So depending on what size you have, depends on where you place this ring. Once this ring is in place correctly, you want to make sure it's even all the way around so it fits in the top groove. This is the piece that goes in first. So this will go into the rim if this was the rim, and then everything sort of locks on top of it, and you sort of work these little teeth in a clockwise fashion until the whole thing pops into place. These are better than the alternative, which is just a standard steel rim. I mean, if you like that sort of thing, that's cool, but kind of made the conscientious decision to give it just a little bit of chrome because chrome is awesome and shiny and no man can resist shiny chrome, so I had to have them. But I didn't want to spend a lot of money for them. So instead of spending I found a cheap set of stainless steel for about $150. Instead of spending $150, I spent about $50 and put the rest towards something else like LED lights that go on the inside. So, but anyway, this is a ABS plastic chromed wheel simulator. Got a set of four. I believe it was right around 50 bucks. I'll put a link in the description and the cost and all that good stuff. But I'm going to put them on and I'll show you what they look like. I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, peanut butter.